Kan shalom, all praise to Yahweh Bashim, Yoshai Bashim, Kakadash, the honest study apostles and elders of Great Millstone, and salutations to the hopeful electors pushing this truth of sincerity. So I was watching this video from Elder Manata Sagba. You know, the statement that was made, Jake says that he can keep every law. It doesn't make any sense to make a statement like that, because when you say you can keep all the laws perfect, then there is no value for Yahweh Shai to come for you, because you're already walking in perfection. You see, there are certain statements that people make which doesn't make any sense, it's just not adding up. The book of Matthew chapter 9 verse 12, but when Yahweh Shai heard that, he said unto them, they that be whole, that's what he's saying, he's already saying like he's whole, he doesn't need a physician, he doesn't need healing. You know, they that be whole need not a physician, which Yahweh Shai is. But they that are sick, we are sick. You know, being in this estate, being confronted with all the chemtrails, the pollution upon this earth, our mind was taken away from knowing who we were and what we had to do unto the Most High. And even being in this truth, we're not walking in the perfection of the keeping of the commandments. It's impossible, you know. It says, but go ye and learn what that meaneth. I will have mercy and not sacrifice, for I am not come to call the righteous but sinners to repentance. You see the purpose of Yahweh Shai. He was sent by the Most High to bring us back unto him, so that we could repent from our sins. And even in this truth, you still sin. The scripture says in the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 7 verse 20. This is just a quick hit, man. For there is not a just man upon earth that doeth good and sinneth not. So when you say that you are without sin, you are denying, you are actually deleting this scripture. If you deem yourself a just man upon this earth, or do you deem yourself most perfect without any form of sin? There is not a just man upon this earth that is doing justly, that is without sin, is what the scripture says. You see what men are doing upon this earth, man. In the book of 1 John chapter 1 verse 5. This then is the message which we have heard of him and declare unto you, that is the Most High is light, and in him is no darkness at all. If we say that we have fellowship with him and walk in darkness, we lie and do not the truth. That's actually the estate that a lot of men are in, which is also the case with them, you know, because if you say you have fellowship, but you're still lacking in understanding concerning the scriptures, and you can utter something like saying that you are, you can keep all the laws perfect, then you simply are not on the level of understanding. But if we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship one with another, and the blood of Yahweh Shai Mashiach, his son, cleanseth us from all sins. And that's what we need. We need our example to walk in it. But every day we need the forgiveness. That's why the scripture says, pray, watch and pray. Pray without ceasing. If we already would be in a perfect state of not committing sin, then there wouldn't be even reason to pray or to ask for the forgiveness of sins. It says, if we say that we have no sin, which that man said, we deceive ourselves. So he deceived himself. And the truth, this word, the Bible, the scriptures, the knowledge, the spirit of the Most High is not in you. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. If we say that we have not sinned, we make him a liar and his word is not in us. So you make the Lord a liar, man. Do understand what you say and what you do upon this earth with your own statements, man. That's why the scripture says every idle word. You know, but man can repent from the things that they say in their ignorance or in their pride. They can return and convert and come back, you know, and acknowledge the mistakes which they make, you know. Or if you just want to abide upon this path, it's going to lead towards destruction, man. It's just going to lead towards destruction, man. Because if you say that you're keeping the commandments perfect, it is actually inherent onto saying that you already are in a new covenant, man. Jeremiah 31. If you say that you are keeping all the laws, that's inherent on being in the new covenant of the Most High, because That's the moment when we're going to be perfect. The Most High is going to place everything inside of us. That's when we will be perfect, man. We ain't perfect, man. We need mercy. We need the grace of the Lord. You know? Jeremiah 31 and 31. But the days come, say the Lord, that I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and with the house of Judah, not according to the covenant that I made with their fathers in the day that I took them by the hand to bring them out of the land of Egypt, which my covenant they break, although I was a husband unto them, saith the Lord. But this shall be the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel. After those days, saith the Lord, I will put my law in the inward parts, and write it in their hearts, and I will be their power, and they shall be my people. And they shall teach no more every man his neighbor, and every man his brother, saying, Know the Lord, for they shall all know me, from the least of them unto the greatest of them, saith the Lord. For I will forgive the iniquity, and I will remember their sin no more. When you make a statement that you are keeping the laws perfect, it is inherent unto saying that you are already in the new covenant, which we ain't yet. Quick hit, Shalom.